everyone. In this video, I wanted to walk you through how you create a YouTube watermark from scratch in Photoshop. So the one you see here, I'm gonna show you how to create it from a blank document all the way to exporting it and putting it on YouTube. If it's your first time on this channel, I make easy to follow Photoshop and tech tutorials 5 times a week. So please consider subscribing. So let's start with a new project. We'll go to File, New, and we want to create a file that's 800 pixels by 800 pixels. So make sure 800 pixel by 800 pixel is what you have here, resolution 150. You want the background to be transparent and all these other settings are fine. And you go ahead and name it YouTube watermark and press create. So once you have your document created here, let me just go ahead and zoom in a little bit so it fills the screen. We want to create a box first. We want to create a square basically. So let's come to our shapes and we want to choose rounded rectangle tool here. And up here for the radius, you want to change the radius to be 15 pixel because that will give you this nice roundness. I'm just gonna press Command Z to undo that. But you want 15 pixels here and you want the fill color to be red. That's the YouTube color that we want. So I'm gonna just select red, or you could just choose this and pick red here. Press okay. And let's go ahead and from the corner here all the way to this corner, let's create that box and let go. So this is the box that you're gonna start with as your background box. Now let's create a second layer. And if I go back here to the one I already created, our second layer was subscribe text. So let me go ahead and go back here. And on this layer, I'm gonna press T to get the text tool. I'm gonna put it here and I'm gonna type subscribe. And let me select it. That was just a Command A on the Mac. I'm gonna select it and I'm gonna make it white. And the size should be probably 150. That's too big, let's try 100. I'm gonna press okay. And I'm gonna press V to bring it right over here. Let's take a look at the other one. The text size was about 100, which is what we have here. So let me click it again. And I'm gonna just get rid of that underline, which I had here previously from a previous project. And I spelled subscribe wrong. So I'm gonna go ahead and fix that. And it looks like I gotta make it a little bit smaller here on this project. I'm gonna press 80 and press okay. So let me go ahead and bring it. And now you could do multiple different things with this, like creating drop shadows and inner shadows, the things that I've done here. But let me just keep going on this creation. So the next thing we wanna do is we wanna create another layer. So if you look over here, I'm just pressing the create new layer icon here. And with the new layer, I'm gonna go ahead and create another box, rounded rectangle tool, and 15 again, but I'm gonna change this color to be white this time because we want to have a white box, and I'm gonna put it somewhere over here. And I'm just using my eyes here, and there we go. So if we go over here, that's that box. So I'm just gonna press okay on that box. I'm gonna press V. If I wanna move it around, I can. And then we want to create a triangle inside of here for the play icon. So let's go to the shape tool. And to create a triangle, we need to use the polygon tool. So pick the polygon tool and change the side from 5 to 3. So up here, go ahead and change the side to 3 instead of 5. So let me go ahead and draw it. And we want to make sure it's pointing this way like a play icon. I'm holding shift to restrict the movement. And I'm gonna let go. I'm gonna make it a little smaller and let go. And we want to change the fill color now to red. And now I could press V to move it to the center of the page. So now we have all the elements we need. We just need to give it some dimensions. And to do that, we need to use some inner shadows. So I'm gonna use the rectangle first, the inner rectangle, the white one. I'm gonna double click it here. And I wanna do inner shadow. So I'm gonna click inner shadow here. And if I click the actual text of inner shadow, it'll bring me some of these options. I could change the opacity to be at 100, at a normal. I could change the angle here to be on the side I want to. I want it to be over here on this side. And then I could start changing the distance to start coming in more, and the size if I wanted to. I think I'll leave it like this and I'll just bring the opacity down a little bit and I'll press okay. So you could keep playing with this. If you bring the size up and then bring the choke up, it's gonna give it a little bit of a different dimension. So play with these settings, see what you like. You could do it to taste, but these are the settings I like. I'm gonna press okay here. And then I'm gonna go ahead and control click and copy layer style. And I'm gonna put those on my text layer here. So I'm gonna go ahead and right click and paste layer style. So it's gonna have the same kind of look that the text layer had. And then I could double click and then choose inner shadow, and I could reduce that so it's not so significant like it was in our box here. Let me go ahead and bring the opacity up a little bit, and then I'll put the size to somewhere like that, and I'll press okay. You could also use another option here, which is turning the bevel on, and you could emboss. So if you use the emboss setting in the bevel and emboss option, it'll basically create this kind of effect where it's basically putting it against that red background. So let me go ahead and turn this off. So that's what the bevel and emboss does. And these are the settings I have for that. So if you like this look better, go ahead and copy those. I actually like this better. I'm gonna press okay. And we also want to copy this one more time, copy layer style. And we wanna put it on this triangle as well. So I'm gonna paste it here. So these two will have the same effect. And we're pretty much done. Now to save it for YouTube, we want to go to File, Export, and Quick Export as PNG. That's one of the options. We want to save it as a PNG, and then go ahead and pick a place where you want to save that. YouTube watermark is fine. Press Save. And now if I go to my desktop, there's my YouTube watermark. So now let me jump into YouTube. I made this in the previous video, but I just want to show you where you could find that. If you go to your Creator Studio, you should see this option branding under channel. So if you go to channel and then go down to branding, that should bring you to this page. And on this page, all you have to do is you should see this, and you could add a watermark. And to add a watermark, just go ahead and choose your file. It's the PNG we created, and go ahead and add it and press save. And press save one more time, and it's going to look just like this on all your videos. It's going to be much smaller than you see on this preview, but that is how you add the watermark on YouTube. I hope you found this useful. Please give it a like and subscribe to this channel. I make Photoshop and tech tutorials 5 times a week, just like this one, and I really hope to see you on the next video. Thank you so much for watching this one.